I am. Together.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. Thanks so much for being here tonight. So, rightly so, Susan said, I am not in the blockchain industry. I'm not about cryptocurrency, although I do find it rather interesting. And thanks, Giselle, for an amazing talk, wherever you are. Very interesting and informative, so well done. So I'd like to enlighten you on a different side of technology and art and fashion. So obviously, whatever you buy, whatever you wear, whatever you sit on has all been designed. So let me take you back before I go there. So I'm, as you can probably tell from my accent, from West Yorkshire, so between Leeds and Huddersfield, a little place called Murfield. Being dual heritage or biracial, you know, I always stood out in a crowd. I've got a big afro, I had freckles, I've got fuller lips, so I used to say to mum, you know, why do I look like this, and try to scrub off my freckles? And mum would say, no, you know, you're being silly, like it's unique, they're beauty spots. And, you know, I've got fuller lips, she'd say, you know, people pay a lot of money for those lips. Don't I know it now? So anyway, at that point, obviously I already stood out, so I thought, you know, I may as well just stand out even more. And I almost formed my own identity. And that was at the age of like 14. So moved to London, went to Kingston Uni, and that is where I created this. So rightly so, I fuse fashion, art and tech, and I specialize in copper the metal. This is obviously wearable art, and this is the point, I graduated in 2013, so this is the point where people was like, oh my God, but what is it? It's not fashion, it's not art. Like, how is a model able to wear it? You know, how do you create it? So it kind of got everybody talking, and that's kind of when I, you know, was kind of thrown into the fashion industry, and I've really enjoyed it. Don't get me wrong, I'm not like anti-fashion, and it's great, and you know, I've enjoyed creating these pieces. But really, there's more to clothing. Like, there's more about me than just clothing, and I hope more about you guys than just clothing. You know, we all love it, we all emerge in it, but you know, there's obviously a lot more to it. So throughout the 4 years that I've had my brand, I've shown at Art Basel Miami, I've worked with the Tate Modern, worked with the Tate Britain, you know, worked with some amazing collaborators like Marc Le Bon, shot this metal piece that I created. I've worked with Andrew Logan, so you know, some really great people in the industry, in the creative industry. But actually the last couple of years, it's been more about technology, only because I don't understand it. I'm like, what is technology? What can I do with it? Like, how can I show an audience, you know, my idea, my concept, my pieces, my work? So let's go on to the next slide, Nat, and I can show you. So my first project was with the Royal Academy of Art. And we created holograms. So I worked with a company called MDH, and they created the Kate Moss hologram at the Alexander McQueen exhibition at the V&A. And I reached out to them and I was like, look, I've got this idea and I don't really understand what holograms are, but I think they look cool and I create things and let's just create some sort of collaborative explosion. And they were like, all right, that sounds interesting. Like, come into the office. So I met them. And they were like, whoa, slow down. Like, what is it that you want to do? I was like, I don't know. Like, I just like holograms and I like fashion and art and tech and let's just create something. So we flew out to Milan. I took all the pieces that I'd made. And this is actually copper. It's called Alcantara. And it's like a carbon neutral, totally sustainable material. And I chose the one where it's like copper wire knitted into the Alcantara. Super sculptural, and obviously you can create amazing shapes with it. And obviously at that point, I was like, okay, I'm getting into the holographic world. I have no idea what that means, but I like the end product. I like the output and the outcome. So you know, we went head filming. I was portraying my concept about, you know, kind of finding yourself and take different paths and different routes, which everybody can relate to. And then at the RA, we had 5 screens, and this is what we showed. This is obviously just a few of, you know, like 20 stills. And for me, and the fashion world and the art world were like, what an emerging brand that works with copper metal, working with a hologram company. And they just couldn't put two and two together. And that's when I thought, okay, I'm onto something. Like, all right, you know, the big boys, Burberry, Zara, they can all do amazing, crazy virtual reality mirrors or whatever, but as an emerging artist or designer, you know, it was quite new and quite unique. So that was the first project, and it got loads of people talking, and they were like, but what, you know, why are you doing holograms? Like, I don't get it. And that is where I'm going to take this opportunity now to say it. So I was on BBC Radio 4 a couple of months ago with one of my favorite artists, Ron Arad. And I, at the end of the conversation, I said, what do you think about technology? And he was like, actually, technology should be used as a tool to aid your process, aid your design, and not to take over it. It's more about enhancing. Because I feel that when you're not in that tech world and you don't necessarily understand technology, and you just see the outcome, you're like, okay, well, you know, what can I do with it? What can it do? But actually, it's about using it to aid and enhance your process and enhance your final outcome, you know, and bring something new to this art world. So that was my first project. Nat, the next slide. So this was a project that I did with a really cool company called Make Me Pulse. And they are an augmented reality company. Oh, they do VR and all sorts of bits. And I showed with them at MNC Saatchi in Golden Square. And this was very different. So it's more about showing an audience my process of what I do with copper metal, but through augmented reality. So rather than being like, this is what I've created, it was more about, look how I create it and the journey through this technology. So again, people would come to my show and they'd be like, but you know, what is this empty space? There's a phone and people are looking through the phone, but there's nothing, I can't see what they're looking at. And then, you know, we were filming people's reactions. And again, it was just that like, oh my God, like what is this? Augmented reality, like all these shapes forming, finding the direction. It's not just an illusion, hierarchy of ideas, creating the foundation. And for me, it's more about educating people that don't necessarily understand art or understand design, creativity, but can see my process through technology. And I think that they just captured it so well. And obviously these are just stills, but I've got the video on my website and whatnot, and you can see all these shapes come together and form one kind of, you know, coherent loop. So that was the augmented reality. Nat, on the last slide. So this is what I'm working on currently. So maybe you guys have heard of her, Sophia. So she's the most famous female icon in the AI world. I saw her in January on the front cover of Stylist magazine, and I was like, hang on a minute, like, who is she? Like, why is she wearing Roxana Olenchik? I want her to wear me. Like, she needs to wear my bombers, she needs to wear my copper metal. So I reached out to David, who's the owner of Handsome Robotics, and I was like, look, I am a designer, and I'm from Yorkshire, and I make copper things, and I'd love to create a robot with you. And he's like, whoa, calm down. Like, let's just start at the beginning. Like, send me your work through. Like, I like your energy. I like what you've got to say, but I want to, you know, what do you want to do? So this was the first project that we did together. This is at COGEX, the largest conference, AI conference in the world. And they'd come over from Hong Kong, and I created this bespoke copper metal piece. Obviously, I'd never met Sophia before, so I'd made this piece in my studio on the mannequin, and I thought it'd be fine to kind of sit around her neck. But actually, at the front of Sophia, you have to keep it open so that you know, all the like electronics and all that tech stuff works. So I had to make sure that I wasn't pressing the metal into her face, like into, because her face just feels like our skin. It's crazy, but amazing. So anyway, I made that piece for her, and then she interviewed me. So it was about, you know, my muse and where I came from and how I've got to where I am and, you know, why I'm interested in technology and all that stuff. Anyway, it's on my website. So that was the first bit I did with her. But the second thing that I'm doing with her, which I'm working on right now, so I'm creating a 3D printed sculpture for her arm because we're collaborating together in Shanghai next month. And she's almost acting as my mentor. Now you guys must think, well, you're crazy. Like, why are you working with this robot? Like, what, you know, what's the point? And loads of people say that to me. And when she was interviewing me, all these people were coming up being like, well, don't you think it's weird? Like, why are you doing this? And I said, you know what? The reason why I'm doing this is for you, like, to show you that me and a human and a humanoid can communicate and break down that barrier. The reason why you think it's weird is because you don't understand it. You're not familiar with what this robot can do. And it goes back to what I said earlier about me and Ron Arad having a conversation on BBC Radio 4. It's about using her as a tool, as an aid to enhance my practice and enhance my, you know, art capabilities. So, you know, at the moment they're working on developing Sophia into, you know, being able to draw, being able to walk. Can you imagine how amazing it would be to have Sophia in my studio, like drawing some bits and then I'm making it? Like, why would I not want that? You know, and I think the minute I started explaining why I love working with her and breaking down that barrier and showing an audience that, look, she can talk, she can, all right, yeah, it's part scripted, it's part banter, but at the same time, you know, I'm interacting with her, she's interacting with me, and when I'm talking to her, she locks her eyes on me and she nods. And that's when you're like, are you sure it's not a, she's not a human? You know, so that's kind of where I'm at. So I'm totally different to blockchain and cryptocurrency and all that jazz, but I'm an artist and I create copper metal sculptures and I love robots and I fuse what I do with technology because I feel that one day, whether it be in 2 years, 5 years, 25, whatever, I feel that it will become just one thing under the kind of umbrella of creativity. There'll be no more barriers. So yeah, that's what I do.